The long-lost masterpiece of renowned painter Juan Luna is finally back in the Philippines and is now on display at the Ayala Museum. The piece was last seen in public more than a century ago and is considered the holy grail of Philippine art. And joining us is the man who tracked down the magnificent painting and brought it back home. We have with us Jaime De Leon, director and founder of Leon Gallery. Jaime, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen. Good morning to everyone.
All right, what a coup. I have to say bravo. First of all, let's talk about the journey. How did you find the painting?
Well, this painting, everyone who has a fascination for Luna would know this painting.
Yeah.
People have seen this in black and white prints, in engravings, any book in the 19th century that had something to do with art. So on my part, it was a quest to find it. But of course, there was no lead. There was no no one told me where it was. But I heard about this sometime in the sometime about 15 years ago from Dr. Eleuterio Pascual,
okay,
who has seen this during the 1980s, about 50 years ago. So he told me how beautiful this painting was, and but it was always in my consciousness that this painting exists. And not like burned during the war or burned by the Padre Rivera.
Okay, so, but wait a second. So Dr. Pascual, you said 15 years ago, told you about the painting, right?
Yes.
And he said it exists. But the question is, how did you search for it? Because it's like you're being Sherlock Holmes, right? Right?
Correct.
So you have a clue. The first clue was, okay, the painting wasn't burned. I saw it, it's there. But it could be anywhere in the world. How did you do it?
So Karen, so what was told to me, it was in a titled family.
Okay.
A family who, of course, you know, dukes and duchesses and counts and countesses. So I have this album. I have this book of the nobilities of Spain and France. So, you know, I'm a little palmukha. So I tried to get in touch with all these titled people, knocking at their doors just to look this holy grail of art. So I had some little progress in them, but I found maybe other Lunas, but not this one. But so finally, in 2014, I got a call that I had to be by the doorstep of a home at 10 a.m. So
in Spain,
yes.
Okay.
And then so I went, and there I was in an, of course, aristocratic home. It's a lordly home.
Yeah.
And I was ushered to the drawing room, and when the door opened, I saw what I couldn't believe.
My
The holy grail of Philippine art. Yeah, so that's what I saw. So, of course, it wasn't easy. Negotiations had to be done. And, of course, when you're a seller, you want the best you can get out of it. So it was a long process, too, of being able to close that deal.
Okay, so I want to start first with a few things you just said, and quickly. So you had a book on nobility, on the royal families in Spain and, well, not royal, but nobility in Spain and in France.
Yeah.
And you said you contacted them. So I'm assuming you emailed maybe their secretary. How would you do that?
I had to befriend some people to get me to these families, to get me to this home.
Oh my gosh.
But of course, when you're looking for the grail, you will do anything and everything you can just to be able to find it, right?
Okay. And the next thing is you kept quiet. I mean, considering in Manila, it's so tempting to tell a friend, hey, you know what? I'm looking for the one Luna painting. And you didn't. You didn't say anything.
Exactly. Nothing. So from 2000, it was already mine since 2014, Karen. But it wasn't here yet.
Yeah.
But I never told anybody, even my closest friends. No, not at all.
Not even your partner? Your partner, no. I mean, seriously.
Yeah, Maybe only Kim. So in 2017, once I got it here already, it was just in a crate. Even my employees didn't know what was inside the crate.
My
but
gosh.
I always tell them, take care of that. It's always in an air-conditioned room. I mean, I always tell them, please make sure it's always safe. But they didn't know what was inside the crate all these years.
Okay, until, my gosh. All right.
Until, okay.
I know, until, wait, until when? When did you tell them?
Okay, until last year, Mariles Gostilo of the Ayala Museum and Joanna Duarte invited me for lunch to raise funds for the Ayala Foundation.
Okay.
So of course, because I'm with Leon Gallery, I mean, they want to do auctions again. So I told them, come on guys, let's find other creative means to make money. Why don't we present something? Of course they were skeptical. What is this something again? So I told Joanna. Joanna is an Ongpin, no? So she's familiar with the works of Luna. So I said, Joanna, Mariles, it is something special. So it piqued their interest. So they were badgering me to ask me, Jaime, what is this special? What is this special painting? They invited me for another lunch, but I was not yet so prepared to
share
tell
it.
Them what it was, to say it. Because I also wanted it to whether it was the right timing, whether it was everything right. So finally I told them, guys, it's the Himen of Himeni. And
oh
then Mariles and Joanna couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
So next step was, it probably is just a copy. It probably is just,
of course.
Right. So I told them, why don't we schedule why don't we open the crate? The crate that I haven't opened for 6 years. So,
oh my gosh.
So Martin, so everything aligned. Martin Arnaldo, the film documentary, the filmmaker. By the way, there's a very good film that relates to the finding of this piece that is also shown in the Ayala Museum, was here. And Martin is very knowledgeable on Juan Luna as well as Ambeth Ocampo. So I asked Martin whether he wants to be on board to present this painting and for a show. And of course, without batting an eyelash, he said yes. So we all met again, and then the rest is history.
My gosh, okay. In paintings like these, we do know that the masters are easily forged, right? Because one, they're dead. So you'd have to really trust that it's their artwork. When you went to that home in Spain, what did the owner of the painting say as the provenance of the artwork that convinced you this is real?
So the family acquired the piece in the 1930s.
Okay.
Of course, Karen, when you're in the trade, when you see something, I mean, connoisseurship
this
plays
is
a
blink.
Role. I mean, when you see something, you see the call. It's just like seeing an Amor Solo. When you see the color, I mean, even the best fakers couldn't fake the colors. So the same way as Luna. And of course, all when you see a 4G, you smell something, you feel something immediately. So there was something in the most aristocratic of settings, in the best, But I must also say that luck and the timing played a role here, because when Dr. Pascual wanted to buy it with all the his resources and perhaps the resources of government, because that was the time of the first Marcos regime, he could have easily gotten it. But the father was still alive.
Oh.
They were not prepared to sell it because the father was attached to this painting. He knew it. Of course, it was an award winner. It was a winner in the Olympics of Art, which is the Paris Exposition. And for this work, 1889 was a very special year for France. It was the year they unveiled the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah. Okay, so Jaime, I'm curious, you bought this painting with your own money? In other words, you didn't get investors to help you?
Karen, I had to work doubly hard. I had to work 18 hours a day just to be able to have this painting.
And have more auctions to have that painting.
More auctions.
Okay, all right. Now, what are your plans? I know you won't tell me. how much you bought the painting, right? So forget that. That's not something you'd reveal, because then it doesn't define the worth of the painting. That's the point, right? So that's a secret you'll keep forever. Or are you willing to share it?
No.
Exactly.
I mean, let's just say it's priceless, Karen.
That's
it's priceless.
It. So yeah, my next question is, what do you intend to do with the painting? I mean, now, you at the end of the day, you're an art lover, yes. You are an auctioneer, and that means business. So is this a painting you are donating, or are you selling this painting?
Well, let me put it this way. My options are open.
Yeah.
One thing for sure, it's not for sale. Of course, people call me, are you selling it? You know, because they know I'm a dealer. But this is not for sale. For now, the piece will be with the Ayala Museum. It is my way of giving back to society. It will be for the Ayala Foundation. Whatever can be extracted from it, it's all theirs. I only get the goodwill out of this. I'm very open further to the Ayala Museum loan. I'm very open to what will become of this painting.
Yeah, because in other countries, I'll be honest, it's the government that buys artwork. That's what you call national...
patrimony.
Yes, patrimony. It's the government that buys them.
True. But in this case, of course, since in a private collection now, well, everything open. Things can happen. I mean, never say never. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Now, my next question is, are you looking for another one, Luna?
That's the thing now, Karen. I was staring at the painting. So, you know, you ask yourself, what's next?
Yes.
You have to find for the next race and the chase, you know? I mean, it's what keeps us alive, what keeps us moving, what keeps us motivated, right?
Yeah.
So I'm on for the next treasure.
Now, the next treasure, I love it. But this is also a coup for you specifically as a professional. I mean, I was supposed to go to the unveiling, but ANC was there. And my friends told me who were there is... You had other art connoisseurs and experts in your field who kept saying, this was supposed to be mine. I wanted this. I thought I was going to get this. And seniors in your field who were saying that, let me not say them on television. And yet here you are, Jaime de Leon. I mean, let's face it, you're quite young. And this is like scoring like several 3 points if you were in basketball, right?
Karen, I had to make, when I saw the painting, I had to make sure I get it. Okay. I had, of course, my other opponents to this were formidable. I mean, they could pay like triple the prices of whatever the price that was. I mean, but I mean, I knew, well, as you say, as a professional and in this trade, I wanted to have it. I wanted to make sure that I get it, and the stars aligned. Let's just put it that way.
All right.
Yeah. Of course.
No, go ahead, Jaime. Finish your thought.
Of course, the reason why they said they could have had it because they saw a picture of this painting with some dealer in Madrid.
Yes.
Okay, they saw a picture, but they didn't know that it was already mine. I mean. That picture was seen, they saw it like maybe 3, 4, 5 years ago, but I already owned it since 2014.
Yes.
So the only reason why that guy had a picture was because I needed his help for the crating and all of that.
Yes.
And then, you know, when some dealers take a photo, they always think it, I mean, they always try to make it appear that they have access to it. So that's the reason. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but if there's one lesson that can be learned off you is really, one, your genuine passion paid off, and then your resilience, your tenacity. Because to actually even find the owner, I think that's where the skill in the whole story is, right? You were tenacious, unrelenting. You didn't give up.
I was makapal mukha, Karen. I made sure I presented myself to the most titled of royal of aristocrats.
Yes.
And Only to find the grail.
I love this story. Well, you know, Jaime de Leon, bravo to you. Really, you served. This is so inspiring. I think it's brought the art. The art industry is alive, but you've taken it to a whole other level. And I have to go to the Ayala Museum because I haven't seen it yet. I will schedule it with you.
And let's implore everybody to see the painting. Because one more, Karen, this painting is a happy painting.
Oh, good.
It's a monument to love. You have to remember, Juan Luna was marrying Paz Padre de Tavera. He was marrying up. It's like marrying a Zobel today, you know, or marrying, you know, when you marry up, right? So he was celebrating that moment of his life, you know, and all the symbolisms in the painting. So in contrast to the Spoliarium,
yes,
La Muerte de Cleopatra, I mean, they are equally great paintings, but they profess death, you know, and all social commentaries. But this painting is all about happiness. It's all about a moment of triumph.
Yeah.
It's everything positive.
All right.
Yeah. And it won an award in the Olympics of Art. That's
one thing. Yes. Yeah. All right. Jaime de Leon, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you, Karen.
Always a pleasure to speak with you.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.
Congratulations.